Ain't nobody here but me, my angels, and my guitar singing. Baby, look how far we've come, yeah.
Hello, 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 beautiful. This is Okiba Anahatara, and I'm listening to Miss India, yes. Private Party, and I want to talk about this. All right, there's a lot happening, of course, always a lot happening, and we want to stay strong, we want to stay solid in the midst of all of this. So I want to give you some a tip today that I'm assuring will be a beautiful blessing to you. But before I do that, let me ask you, how are you? Are you well? Are you smiling? Are you feeling at peace? If you're not, what are you doing to get there? What are you doing to smile? What are you doing to get your thoughts and your body in a space where it can find its peace? What are you doing? I'm sharing tips with you guys. Are y'all using them? Are you using those tips? Am I speaking to the choir? I hope I'm speaking to the choir. If not, I hope that you are utilizing some of the things that I'm sharing with you because they are effective and beneficial. Yes, we got to keep our heads clear, right? This is a part of being a beautiful woman and being a beautiful light in this world, but you have to find those spaces for peace in your mind. But today I want to talk about some things, being able to find those little bits of joy. In this song, how India talks about how she tried to go to her mom, and her mom was like, I don't have time, baby. And she tried to go to a boyfriend, you know, he didn't have time either. But what I want to speak with you about is finding that little bit of joy, something that you can do every day. Every day. And I'm not going to tell you the thing that you can do, but I want you to look for that thing that you can do. Here's a way to maintain your happiness, or to keep on trudging through, to keep on keeping on. Here's the tip. Have something that you look forward to doing every single day. Every single day. Okay? And it doesn't have to be something big. We're not talking about, oh, I have this vacation, this trip. It's coming up in 2 months. No, no, no. And you keep thinking about, that's awesome. That's good. Have that in your mind. But I want you to have something that you can do every single day that it puts a little sparkle in you. It makes you smile a little bit, right? It makes you smile a little bit. It doesn't have to be anything big at all. It could be you have a favorite show that you like to watch and you put that on. It could be I just enjoy taking my evening showers and putting on some warm PJs and sliding in my bed. I might have some, you know, you may have some silky pajamas and you just love being in your bed. Maybe you do a foot massage. You have a massage machine that you invested in. And maybe every day you sit in there, you do that, right? Something that you can look forward to doing and experiencing every single day. And it gives you a smile when you think of it like, oh, I can't wait. That's good. Now, I want to give you some criteria for it. If this is something that you don't do already, I want to give you a little bit of criteria for it to help you find that thing, right? First thing is that this thing that you select that you'll do every day should not be damaging or detrimental to you, right? So if your one thing is, oh, every day after the kids go to bed, I'm gonna get me a slice of chocolate cake before I go to bed. You might wanna rethink that one. Because after a while, it's gonna put some pounds on you and do some things that you're not gonna be happy about. So that may not be a good one. It may not be a good one to indulge in some alcoholic beverages, some beer or whatever else. Some people do, they do enjoy a glass of wine, and you know, there are benefits to drinking red wine at you know, in the evening and such. So if that's your thing, go ahead with it. Put on some jazz music, put on some soft music, whatever you like to do. Take a nice bath and you look forward to it. It needs to be something that you really look forward to doing. It makes you smile. You feel a smile coming on your face, or you feel in your heart like, oh, I can't wait. You're thinking on it like that, okay? That sort of thing. Something that you can think about that makes you smile. The second criteria is that this is something that doesn't require someone else, right? It's something that you are able to do alone. So, for instance, let's say you're thinking, you know, if you're thinking in your mind like, ooh, me and my boo, my man, my boo thing, we hook up. you know, in the evenings, we get together, and, you know, that's something I look forward to every night. And that's awesome. That's awesome, amazing, that's delicious, that's wonderful. But what if your boo thing ain't there, right? Are you going to be not so happy? You know, if you can think about it and in your mind that gives you joy, then go with it. If not, then try to find something, again, that doesn't require the attendance of someone else. That somebody else doesn't have to be there in order for you to experience that joy, right? Remember that happiness, I should say. Think about what India talked about in here. She had to find the joy inside of her. She had to find those things that made her happy. It's just me, my guitar, and my angels. And I'm saying, look how far I've come. And that's what I want you to do. That's what I want you to be. That's where I want you to be, okay? So you don't have to have someone else there with you in order to experience this little bit of happiness. This is about snatching a little bit of happiness every single day. A little something to be smiling about for yourself each and every day. Something that you do for yourself each and every day, okay? The third criteria that I'm going to suggest that it's something that you already have the materials. You already have the materials for. You don't have to go out and buy some big old equipment. Like I mentioned, exercise equipment. Maybe you want to do that, but maybe if you don't have that, find something else that you can do in-house that you already have. It's already around you. Like maybe you like to curl up with a book. Get a good book. Get back into reading. Reading novels, if that was your thing, if that's your thing, read some books. You know, do something that enjoys. I had a friend who was into... I can't think of it right now. Somebody help me out when you in the descriptions. When you have your binders and scrapbooking, that's it. She was really into scrapbooking. She loved it. I mean, I've known two sisters to do that, and they just loved it. It was a hobby for them. And they just do it. They put it together. They get all kinds of little artifacts and leftover this and leftover that and just made a beautiful hobby out of it. You know, you may play an instrument. You might want to learn how to play an instrument. Through this whole pandemic thing, I've learned how to play the piano. Still learning. I'm not great, but I've learned how to play some songs, and I enjoy doing that. It's something that I enjoy doing. So that's one of the things that I look forward to doing. Unfortunately, I wouldn't call that my thing only because oftentimes I don't do it every day. But it is something that when I think about playing it, I feel really good playing that piano. There is something that I do look forward to doing every day. So I'm going to share with you guys my thing. I always try to find a show that I look forward to watching. And so right now my show is, y'all, look, don't judge. My show is, there's a show called Downton Abbey. Downton Abbey. How many of y'all heard of this? Right, Downton Abbey. Look, I like to watch different things. I like to check out some different things. And oftentimes when I look at shows, when I look at dramas, oftentimes I step outside of Black and African American and such, because many times those shows contain the drudgery, the pain, the brokenness of that Black people have experienced in this country. And I've seen enough of that. I've seen enough of that. I want to see some different things. And you can get caught into it. The same way you can get into a book, you can get into the storylines and like, wow. And you just get into it and take pleasure in great writing, you know, really good writing and acting, you know, and appreciate the arts. Appreciate the art of a good storyline. And so I enjoy, that's my show that I'm watching right now. I have different shows that I watch. Do something different. And I'm really saying that to a lot of my sisters. Like I said, this channel is for anyone, but I focus a lot of it on African American women. But any woman, any person can enjoy this channel. If you get something from it, I appreciate you. I'm glad you do. I want to be a blessing to you. But find something else. And so when I'm saying directing at Black women, we have to sometimes step outside of that box of just doing things that are Black. If all the music you listen to is Black music and all the shows you watch are Black and all the news commentary and all the everything is always Black all the time, then you kind of tunnel vision yourself into a way of thinking that understand it's more than just us on the planet. You can learn things from other people. You can learn things about history. You can pick up tips. You can, there's so many things you can learn. There's so much to it. If you find a good show, if you find a really good book that steps outside of your ethnicity, there are many things that you can learn that other people can even teach you. And sometimes it can help you deal with even some of these race issues that are going on in our society right now. Sometimes you tackle some of these things within the home and dealing with them, learning how to analyze some of these things when you're in the safe space of your own home and deal with that, as well as spiritual aspects of all of this, learning how to deal with that in your home. And then you take it out into the street, and when you meet people, you may have a different perspective. You'll be surprised how much you can grow just by simple things like that. So getting back to the point about all of this is finding a little happiness every single day. That's what I'm going to encourage you to do. Things may get a little harder and a little uglier before the light of day fully comes, but we are all here now in this space because we all can make it through. But you want to make it through on the other side stronger than you were before. You want to come out happier than you were before. You want to come out in a better place than you were before. Part of that is maintaining, right? Tarrying along in the walk. And a good part of that, something that'll help you do that, is finding little happiness every single day. And you got to find that within you and find that in your own space, not depending on anybody else, but you finding that for yourself. All right, that's it for now. If you know of anyone who might enjoy watching this video, please send it to them. If you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and do so. And that's it for now. I will see you next time. Our beautiful Flow Friday. Be beautiful always. Peace.